after that, I didn't need it ever again. That's the thing about LSD, you don't need it twice.
You've only taken it once?
Oh no, I took it lots of times. But I only needed it once.
Turn off your mind, relax and float downstream.
Harrison was the one for whom the Indian mystical period and the mind-expanding psychedelic period gave a measure of power. As soon as Harrison took the sitar into the studio, he became important, because up to that point, George Martin, the producer of the Beatles, was terrible to him. He used to say, you will play these notes. Here they are on the piano. You will play this. He was the underdog of the Beatles. He was the one who had the most miserable time. Harrison was very much younger, in particular, than Lennon, and Lennon used to patronize him and call him that kid. That stuck for an awful long time. That's another root of this sort of resentment and this feeling of discomfort and rancor that he had as a Beatle.
In an interview before his death, John Lennon said he was really hurt by you, that you'd never mentioned in your autobiography any of the influence that he had on you.
He was annoyed because I didn't say that he had written one line of this song, Taxman. But
did you tell him that?
Well, I didn't, because he was already dead after that. But the point to that was that I also didn't say how I wrote two lines to Come Together or three lines to Eleanor Rigby. You know, I wasn't getting into any of that. I think in the balance, I would have had more things to be niggled with him about than he would have with me.
But he said that you idolized him as a young boy, that you thought...
Well, that's what he thought.
And you didn't?
Well, I liked him very much. He was a groove. He was a good lad. But at the same time, he misread me. He didn't realize who I was. And this was one of the main faults of John and Paul. They were so busy being John and Paul, they failed to realize who else was around at the time.
Yeah, okay, well, I don't mind. I'll play, you know, whatever you want me to play. Or I won't play at all if you don't want me to play. So whatever it is, please, I'll do it.
I don't think the Beatles fulfilled everything that George wanted to do by any means. And I think that perhaps he felt sometimes a bit of a junior member. And the other thing is, he doesn't want to be spend all his life as an ex-Beatle.
Michael Palin, once a member of Britain's Monty Python, has appeared in Harrison's films and remains a close...
What condition was he in when he was in your car?
In the shot.
There were about six officers carrying him. He had a little bit of blood coming out of his mouth.
He was dead at the moment that the first shots hit his body.
I'd like to know where you were when John Lennon died.
I was in bed.
I wondered what you felt, losing someone close to you for all those years.
It's like losing your parents or anybody you know and love. You know, all things must pass, but when it's taken in a violent way like that by somebody else, it makes it very strange. He was very good. He was very good, and he was... in some ways, he was a slight genius. I mean, but apart from that, he was still just some guy like the rest of everybody else.
He was no angel.
He wasn't, but he was as well.
Was he?
Yeah. So, okay, one of your best friends got assassinated, so surely you must be nervous about being assassinated too. You know, I like to take care, but I don't walk around fearing for my life, and I don't think, you know, anybody could be bothered killing me. You know, what's the point of killing me? There's nothing, you know, I don't feel that important.
Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, and that's it, it's all right.
So strange, but it's just another one of the strange things that's happened in this life. You know, our manager died, our road manager was shot by the LA police. So many of our friends died through the years, and, you know, everybody went on drugs, everybody went to the Himalayas, everybody got divorced. You know, it's just a very concentrated kind of life.
It's all right.
The whole thing has been like this, really, in one way or another.
it's alright.
Just sort of get used to it.
Thank you very much. Thank you.